1985 was a good year. It was a good year for chocolate, and it was a good year for this company, and we've had some good times because of it. But tonight is a sad night. It's a sad night because we're losing a friend, but more than that, we're losing a colleague. Gordon Inglis, who joined us, what?
18 months
ago from Leicester, is leaving us to head up a high-powered team, as you might expect, with our US division based out of Ohio. Now, one thing our US cousins ought to know about Gordon, apart from don't ever play squash with the guy, right? No. Gordon is a guy who knows more about brand profiling a chocolate confection than even I do. Gordon.
I first met this loony when our boss, John Dowling, got Stuart here to head up a team to brand a new high-profile, top-end, count-line confection bar on the housewife impulse buy indulgence end of the snack market. That project, as you know, became the chocolate knob. Still, I'm happy to say, brand leader. But Stuart arrived in Leicester, where I was based out of, and he booked himself into the Holiday Inn there. I guess he heard they had the biggest minibar around, right? And he gave me a ring.
From my car?
From your car, yeah. To my car, but in fact, at the time, I happened to be on the other line. But eventually, we got in touch. And you let me know you were in town.
I should say that I told John Dowling, when the whole caboosh was first mooted, that I had but one worry. There wasn't a worry about budget. I knew I could get a budget out of John. My worry was, could I get Gordon? Because, and I don't want to embarrass you here, Gordon, but if you've got Gordon playing on your team, you're halfway to the end zone before first time out.
Listen, I don't know so much about end zones or timeouts, but I could tell you a story about this nutter that shows you just exactly what high brand profile management is all about. I'm on a plane with this guy flying out to Bahrain on a sales probe one time.
Wild days.
Wild days. The idea is it's part of a push to get a chocolate knob into every mouth in the Arabian Gulf. And Stuart here, we're on the top deck of a 747, we're flying Bicol club class. And Stuart here sees a hostess who takes his eye.
Oh, I don't like the sound of this.
Given what you said to her, Stuart.
Oh, good Christ Jesus, no, I don't remember that.
You said to her, get your knickers down, girl.
Why waste time, Ryan? Hmm? I mean, it worked. She stroked my cheek.
She slapped your face.
Yeah. No, but look, I mean, if we're telling Bahrain stories, I should say, we arrive at Bahrain Airport.
Oh, whoops.
And we're being met by Sheikh Kazim al-Rashid. Now, he's an Arab. He's been sitting on the chocolate knob for us out there. And we get into his car.
Oh, this isn't a story about how I threw up in the back of his car, is it? Go on, tell it.
And Gordon threw up in the back of his car.
You bastard for telling that story.
All right, we've told some stories, we've had a few laughs, but you know, everywhere, there has to be a bottom line.
Right.
You know, people, they talk, don't they, about the love between a man and a woman, and for sure, that's got its place, no one would deny that. But you know, there's another kind of love, a love between colleagues that's based on respect for performance. I'm not a homosexual. Never have been.
Neither am I.
I think our records show that, but I have to tell you here tonight, John, with your permission, that I love this guy. I love this big, crazy, flyaway Royster Doyster. I love him. Gordon, I love you.
Stuart, you're giving me a lump.
Christ, I'm gonna miss you. Get over here.
You bastard.